In this video, I'll show you how to combine two images, your professional engineer's seal and your signature, into one image. As a professional engineer, you must have this combined image in order to e-seal a record set using Adobe Sign. This video shows the steps for Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, the document cloud version. If you're using Adobe Acrobat Pro 11, please see the companion video for that version. The techniques are the same, but there are some differences in where you find and how you use the tools in each version. There's more than one way to combine these images, depending on the software that you have and that you're comfortable using. In this video, I'll follow the same steps that Tom used in his Acrobat Pro 11 video. So start with a plain 8.5 by 11 sheet of white paper and sign your name on it. Be sure to sign your name as it appears on your license. You may want to sign in several places so you have some options to choose from. You don't have to sign in color, but if you do, it looks more authentic. So after I signed my sheet of paper, I scanned it, saved it to my computer as signature file PDF, shown here. Here's how my signature file looks in Acrobat. Now, I scanned the whole page, so this file is still 8.5 by 11 inches. If I tried to combine this with a seal now, it would either completely cover the seal or the signature would be way too small to read. So remember that per the AES board rules, the seal is mandated to be 1 5/8 or 1.625 inches square. Before I can fit my signature on a seal, I need to crop it to get rid of the extra white space. And because this is a PDF file, I'll also need to save the cropped signature as an image file or picture file. I'm first going to zoom in so that it's a little bit easier to work with the signature. There we go, that should work. Okay. Now on the right side menu, I'm going to choose Edit PDF. I'll open the Edit PDF toolbar at the top. Notice the Crop Pages button here. If I hover over that, you'll see the tooltip. Click and select area, then double-click to crop. So that's what we're going to do. So I'll click the button, and then I'll draw a box around my signature. Now you can click and drag and move where the box is. You can grab a hold of the handles at the corners and resize the box. What you want to try to do is to get the box to just get to the edges of your signature. Sorry, got rid of it. Click outside of it, it goes away. You just draw a new one and it comes back. You want to include your entire signature with as little white space as possible. When you're done, double click. That will open this dialog box. Shows you the area of the screen that you have selected. Shows you the dimensions of that area. You don't need to make any changes here. So just click the OK button. You now have a cropped signature. But this is still a PDF file. I need to save it as an image file, as a picture file, to combine that with my seal. So from the File menu, choose Export To, then choose Image. And you can use any of these four image types, JPEG, JPEG 2000, TIFF, or PNG. My seal is already a JPEG file, so I'm going to go ahead and save my signature as a JPEG. The original file name was signature file. I'm going to call this signature file cropped. Save that so we can find that later. So if we go back to File Explorer, you can see that I have my blank PE seal, an image file, my cropped signature, and then the original signature that we just edited. I have those two images. I need to combine them. Again, you can use any image editing software that you want to combine your two images. Microsoft Paint 3D has the advantage of being included with most versions of Windows and having just enough features to do what we need. So I'm going to open the seal in Paint 3D, then open the signature, and then combine the two images. If I right-click on the seal image, one of the options in the shortcut menu is Open With, and from there I'll choose Paint 3D. Here's the seal. Now, I'm not an engineer, so this is a sample seal from Acorn Sales. Now, I opened that image. Paint 3D only lets you work with one image at a time. So if I now open the signature, it's just going to replace the seal. In order to combine the two images, I need to use the Insert command instead. So from the menu, I'm going to choose Insert. And then I'm going to open my signature file. Now, you have to be careful. Okay, zoom is going a little crazy here. You have to be careful at this point. You can move the signature by clicking and dragging inside the box. You can resize the signature by grabbing a hold of one of the handles, either on the corners or on the edges. But if you click outside the signature, Paint 3D is going to assume that you're done and that that's where you want the signature to stay. If you do that by accident, you'll have to undo that. So I'll insert my signature again. I'm going to zoom in like I did in Acrobat to make it a little easier to work with. You can resize it from the corners, trying to keep the aspect ratio good so that the name doesn't look too distorted. Continue to shrink that until it looks like a good fit for the seal. The AES board rules don't say how large your signature has to be, just that it must cover the seal. And when you combine one image on top of another, the top image blocks out a rectangular area of the image below, as you can see here. It's okay to cover some of the dots, but you probably don't want to cover any of the text. Also remember that Adobe Sign will automatically add the date here below the license number. So you need to position your signature far enough down to leave room for the date. I think that's probably close. Go with that. And then once you're happy with the size and position, you either click outside the box or press the escape key, and then save your combined image. File, save as, image. And since we already have the blank PE seal, how about if we call this the signed PE seal? So now we have the signed seal. And if we open that up in Windows Photo Viewer, it looks like that. There's our seal with a signature and bind on top of it. That's all there is to it. You're ready to use your seal to seal record sets.